In this After Effects tutorial, I'll show you how to create a title animation based on text only. Hi, my name is Manuel. Depending on the text and the font you use, it looks very different each time, so stick around. To follow along, you might want to download the project file. Ready? Let's dive in. This is our text comp. I've already added a text layer. Let's grab it and drag it down here on the Create New Composition icon, which surprisingly creates a new comp and adds the text comp to it. We quickly name the comp title animation. Let's take care of the timing and set some markers. We want the first cut to be at 12 frames, the second one at 24 frames. So the animation has three parts. The beginning, which starts slow but quickly takes up speed. The middle, which holds the speed. And the end, where everything slows down and the title is revealed. Let's set it up. We add a new solid, which we name mask. Color white. Then we switch to the track matte menu down here and turn it into the alpha matte for our text comp. Next we add a mask, shift command N and press command T to rotate it 45 degrees. And if you hold shift while rotating, it will be exactly 45 degrees. Then let's form kind of a stripe, which covers the first few letters. You might want to leave some space to the left for longer titles. Important is that the mask reaches beyond the screen. Then we duplicate the two layers, grab the left edge of the mask and move it to the right to form a new stripe, maybe like that. We duplicate the last two layers again, grab the left edge again and create another stripe, this time a much slimmer one. Once more, a bigger one, then maybe a very slim one. And the last one, again with some space to the right for longer titles. So it's six stripes altogether. And I don't know if you can see it, there are these black thin lines between the stripes, which is really annoying. So we need to open the mask properties and add an expansion of 0.5 pixels to each of them. Just to be sure it looks good. Then we select all layers, split them at 24 frames in the timeline, shift command D. Let's move all the new layers to the top. Alright, let's have some fun and animate. We start with the end part. We move to 45 frames and set a position keyframe for the top text layer, which is the last part of the title. Then we jump to the cut and move the comp down in a 45 degree angle. To make that easier, let's add some guides. New solid, command Y, color pink maybe. And let's add Venetian blinds. Transition completion around 90%, direction minus 45 degrees. Now simply move along these lines. Anyways, let's move this last part down to maybe here. And let's move the guide layer down to the bottom. Then we select the two keyframes and open the graph editor. Make sure the snap icon is activated and edit speed graph is selected. And we drag this right point down and its handle as far to the left as possible. Then we move the left point down to the line and pull the handle as far to the left as possible. Fast start, then a very smooth end. Let's go to 35 frames and set a position keyframe for the second text comp. Then we jump to 24 frames and move it up a bit. Maybe like this. Again, quickly adjusting the speed curve. Then we go to 29 frames, leave out the third text comp, take the fourth instead, set a position keyframe. Jump to 24 frames again and move it up a tiny little bit. Don't forget to adjust the speed curve for a smooth animation. Alright, the end is done. Let's animate the middle part. We jump to 12 frames, select all these bottom layers and move the start point to 12 frames. Then we deselect the mask layers by holding command while clicking on them. Then press S to open all scale properties of the text comps. We scale these comps up between, let's say, 300 and 1200%. Which makes them really pixely, so we need to activate this little star here to continuously rasterize them. Oh, looking sharp again. We select all the text comps. This time we press P to open the position properties and jump to 23 frames and set a keyframe for all of them. Then we position the comps. Move them around a bit to see different letters but we want to keep it mostly centered in the middle here. Next, we jump to 12 frames and move the positions up and down. Let's start with down. Then up and so on. Alright, looks nice. Almost like some sort of sliced glass reflections. The end is near. Let's move to the beginning. We select all middle part layers, duplicate them, and move them down into the beginning. Then we deselect all masks, hold Command while clicking on them, open the scale property, and scale them up even further, all at once. Let's expand the left and right mask so the text covers the whole screen. Then we select all text comps, open the position property, click on position to select both keyframes, grab it either here at the top point or here at the bottom, and move both points down along the guidelines. You need to be on one of the keyframes in the timeline to make this work. Next, we move it up. Down. Up, down, and so on. So the text is not as centered as in the middle part, still all over the place. Now we select all first keyframes, open the graph editor, grab the top point, move it down and pull the handle to the right, and all the others should follow. Then we select the right points and pull the handles as much to the right as possible. Okay, almost there. One last thing though. We should change the content position within the stripes for more variety. In order to do that, we use the anchor point property. This is how you quickly set up a very unique title animation. On the left side, I've added some videos you might like, so see you there in a second. Subscribe to my channel on the right side, I'd really appreciate it. And hit the bell 'cause you don't want to miss on anything here. Thanks so much for watching. See you in the next video. Bye!